There are many features available for doing quick and easy pivot analyses of the data. Both rows and columns provide a variety of features for accessing and drilling into the various hierarchical levels in the table. If you come up to any of the rows, you'll notice a menu icon appear next to it. If you open that, you have an option for expanding, collapsing, hiding an option for the end users to expand if you are in development mode, or being able to insert a row. For the navigation experience, let's come up to expand, and our first option, which is all, will expand all the levels below it. We can also expand down to the level below the one we are at, or all descendants below this level. Additionally, we can also go to any specific level. As an example, let's go ahead and navigate to category. And now that expanded our entire matrix table down to the category level. You can also individually expand or collapse any of these levels by using the plus or minus icons that are here. The columns can also be individually opened and expanded using the arrows here, if we open that. Additionally, you have the menu over on the left, which also gives you similar options that you had on the row to expand or collapse all, as well as being able to go to a specific level. You can also choose to sort this category either ascending or descending. You can also configure the navigation experience of the icons or settings either for the rows or columns by coming up to display, navigating to hierarchy, and there's a couple of useful features down here. The first one is showing the child count, which will show the number of children below any category in the hierarchy. You can also choose to change the symbols from the default, which is plus and minus in a square, to multiple other ones below, or you can disable them entirely. Additionally, you have an option to configure this down here for the row expand and collapse to either have it be always present, or if you'd show only on hover, the symbols will now only show up if you hover over the visual itself. Similarly, the native calculations will also include this symbol as well here to give you an option to sort, either descending or ascending, and any of the calculated measures will have the f of x symbol, which will also open up the same type of menu. Additionally, these columns can be hidden either using the menu here or coming up to manage columns. In this case, let's go ahead and hide the variance calculation, leaving just the variance percentage remaining. Additionally, you have one other way to show or hide columns using the home ribbon. In a similar fashion, if we went ahead and selected one of the rows here and we had a desire to hide this, we can select that, come up to the home ribbon, click the hide icon, and now that row will be hidden. Additionally, if you open this menu up, you'll also have an option to show all columns or all rows that have been hidden. Go ahead and collapse the United States hierarchy. Now, one other thing we can do is if we selected United States and Canada, we can add a custom group by coming up and selecting this, giving this a name, selecting apply, and just like Excel, we now have a new group name above it, which can also be individually formatted where we can center it, we could do things such as underline it, even changing the text color or the background color. You can do a similar process with multiple rows. If I was to select washers and dryers and water heaters, come up to group again and give that a name, select apply. We have now grouped those into a new category called high cost appliances that is also stored within the hierarchical structure. We also have an option to apply a top in if we want to see the top performing categories with the option to display others as well. Let's go ahead and select this and let's decide to display a top three based off of category with the option to show the rest as others. So let's select apply. And as an example in Contoso, we now see our top three product category with an others category showing with the count of product categories inside of that. Another great feature is the ability to choose the aggregation type for the values displaying. As an example, if we came to home appliances, expanded washers and dryers, I'm now showing the individual sales order ID information in here and its sum total. Instead of what I can do is come up to advanced, go to aggregation, and instead of native, I could change it to the min, the max, either the average of the children or the leaf, standard deviation, or visible rounding. Let's go ahead and change it to the minimum, which now at the subtotal level is 99.90,000. And if we scroll all the way down to the bottom down here, we can see that's the minimum value at the sales order ID level. Additionally, you can also access the aggregation type by coming up to manage columns, go into advanced settings, and for any of the calculations in here, you'll have a dropdown to choose the aggregation type. Another great feature is the ability to add or configure various totals and subtotals. We come up to the home ribbon, select total. Let's start by enabling Show Row Grand Total, which will add a total row here at the top. Additionally for that, you have the option to freeze totals. This is only enabled if you do not have pagination turned on and you can scroll through your matrix table. If you turn this on, and you'll see when you scroll through that the all total at the top stays fixed at the top of the table. We can also come back up to totals, turn on the column grand total, which will add a grand total by default over here on the right. And another useful feature if we open this up is enabling row subtotal split. By default, the row subtotal will be on the same row as the category name. If we turn this on, we now see that it gets a separate row at the bottom for the subtotal. And last but not least, if we come up here and go to positions, we can actually configure the location of any of the various grand totals or subtotals. And one other really useful feature for analysis is the ability to quickly and easily get all the data formatted to reduce the white space so it can fit onto the page for analysis of the data. That can be accessed on the home ribbon by coming up and selecting best fit, which will compact the data down and make it more readable in a smaller form.